The next year, 57, my brother and I thought that we'd do a similar sort of trip, but this time with a motorcycle, a bigger one. We got to England, and it was some holiday, so we couldn't go to the motorcycle company to try to get a free motorcycle. And so we went on to Germany, to Munich, to the BMW factory. And I remember, they couldn't give us one, but they were struck by the fact that such a trip would be good publicity for the motorcycle. And so they charged us only $300 for a motorcycle that must have been worth several thousand, or at least now, I think it's around 15,000 for such a vehicle. Anyway, off we went. And this time, we had no difficulty getting into the Soviet Union, and it was very helpful that we had not only ordinary visas for Russia, but it was at a time when there was a communist youth get together. You didn't have to be a communist, but it was sponsored by the Communist Party, and they welcomed youth from all over the world. There were very, very few Americans that dared to defy the unofficial ban that the State Department put on going there. I mean, you could still go, but the State Department wasn't particularly keen on having Americans go there. So when we got to Hungary, because in part we had this youth festival thing in mind, you know, it was sort of a stamp of approval. It got us through more easily. I remember when we got there. There were, of course, Russians from all over the Soviet Union there, and there was a party that they gave the American delegation, which I don't know, there's very few people, but a party where they gave a prize from each, or from several of the Soviet republics. And one of them was this beautiful Siberian rug, which we won. And this fellow American, Larry Moyers, who's become a great friend of mine over the years, and a very funny comic from Brooklyn, complete with the appropriate Brooklyn accent, when he saw that we got the rug, which had an inscription in Russian, which of course none of us understood, Larry said, "Well, you see that inscription? You may have some difficulty when you get to the customs in America, because the translation of it reads, and I'll translate it for you, it reads, 'Thanks for the blueprints.'" And of course, he was joking. To this day, I don't know what it said. It could be that it said that, but for all I know.